Good evening and welcome to the Lawrence City Council meeting. Today we're having a regular meeting. It's March 2nd, 2016. Mr. Clerk, roll call please.
Council Reyes.
Present.
Council DePena.
Present.
Council Rodriguez. Council Abdu.
Present.
Council Almonte.
Present.
Council Maldonado.
Present.
Council Alvarez Rodriguez. Council Vice President LaPlante.
Present.
And Council President Vasquez.
Present. Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Can you please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Councilors, please join me in a moment of silence. Thank you. For the record, we don't have any prior meeting minutes that needs to be approved. Now moving on to public participation. Mr. H. Malley.
Good evening, honorable members. Mayor Rivera campaign promise of safe Lawrence only possible you as our elected official and Mayor Rivera's support of our police department and the senior officers union. Our police department under impeccable leadership of Honorable Chief Fitzpatrick has done excellent job to protect our citizens, stand up for our police officers and support their union. Our city has been great city because of our hardworking DPW workers. A few workers and the best leadership, our DPW workers are the best. We, the citizens, demand of you support our DPW workers in their collective bargaining negotiation. Fire after fire, our brave firefighters sacrifice their safety so our citizens be safe. We, the citizens, demand of you and Mayor Rivera support our firefighters and their union. Our public school with the best leadership of Honorable Superintendent Rally is moving forward. Turnaround plan has created the best public school in the nation. Our public school has more high school graduates, more MCAS improvement, the Family Resource Center. We, the citizen, demand of you and Mayor Rivera support our teachers and their union. Remember your campaign promise, Save Lawrence. Prosper Lawrence is only possible. You as our elected official support our police department and their union, our firefighters and our DPW. Let's move forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Malley. Next person in line is Dick Blashford.
Good evening.
Good evening, Mr. Blashford.
Dick Blashford, 3 Harrison Street. Short and sweet tonight. The other day, I had lunch with my oldest son, David, and something he had said to me reminded me of when he was in kindergarten a lot of years ago. He had several classmates who, when they were not picked for certain games or to lead something at the school, they became vengeful and nasty to some of their classmates or babbled on and on about how badly they were treated and then got even angrier when classmates laughed and snickered at them. Basically, their parents had no control. And these same kids carried this through to sports in high school. Believe me, I know. I had several of them when I coached hockey. And they spent a lot of time on the bench because they just couldn't handle their anger and vengefulness. Well, a lot of the folks in the city of Lawrence feel it's probably time to close down the kindergarten wing of the city council and for members to act like adults and put their big boy pants on and do the job they were elected to do and represent the people and not their own personal vendettas and endless babbling. The citizens honestly are getting tired of the drama. Let's move the city forward, not backwards. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Blashford. Next person in line is Dick Russell.
Good evening, councilors. Excuse me. My name is Dick Russell, reside at 34 Cross Street. I want to discuss 4 issues with you tonight. First, Why do we even have an even-odd parking ban where there's no snow on the ground and isn't any forecast in the foreseeable future? This is particularly frustrating to those of us who don't have a driveway and are totally at the whim of a totally asinine city ordinance, at least for this winter. Maybe the council could dream up some sort of change to this ordinance to account for abnormal weather. Wouldn't be the first time the council declared something to be handled as an emergency. Next, it's gotten back to me some councilors aren't happy with my posting of information about their political campaign funds on my Facebook page. Well, folks, let me say this. Everything I post comes from public records, readily available from the Office of Campaign and Finance website. My suggestion to those who do not like my snooping into their personal information is either follow the law or take Harry S. Truman's advice, that being, if you can't stand the heat, get out of the kitchen. As an afterthought to my above comments, it appears that those that complain the most and the loudest seem to do the least for the city. I have also heard people suggest putting a time clock on the wall and pay the councilors for time that they're actually seated at the council desk performing the duties they're elected to do. What a novel idea. Third, why do citizens have to put up with this foolish $50 limitation on cash transactions to the city? If you don't trust the people handling the cash, then either get honest people or require that the ones handling the cash be bonded. It seems stupid that I should have to get a check or a money order to pay a $58.75 auto excise tax bill. Finally, good news. I have discovered that the Foundation for Transparency in Government has formed a political action committee, number 80959. Like a lot of things in Lawrence, a day late and a dollar short. Now, if we could only see their financial information. As always, I thank you for the time.
Thank you, Mr. Russell. Next person in line is Kathy Runge. Good evening.
Good evening. Kathy Runge, 32 Draycott Street. I'm here to talk about the school committee appointment that you'll be discussing later. I hope you know that the state is going to be watching to see who you choose for this position, and I'm sure it'll factor into the decision as to when they think that this city is ready to run its own schools. Now, at the Committee of the Whole meeting where you discussed this, a member of the school committee spoke in favor of one of the candidates, saying that, well, the best choice might be different if the school system wasn't in receivership, but since it was, that this person here would be a very good choice. Well, I'm here to say that the city council should be appointing school committee members, if it falls to you, as if the school system isn't in receivership. If you ever hope to get control of our schools again, you know, we should be showing that the city can make intelligent and the best decisions for the school system in the city. In closing, some members of the city council have criticized the current mayor for not always hiring the most qualified people for jobs. Well, here's your chance to show them how it's done. Hire the most qualified person.
Thank you, Ms. Runch. These names will be submitted for the record. At this moment, I'd like to excuse Councilor Nilka Alvarez-Rodriguez. She notified me that she wasn't going to be able to make it for tonight's meeting. Moving on to the public hearings, Mr. Clerk, please read notice for document 31715.
Document 317-2015. Notice is hereby given the City Council will hold a public hearing on Wednesday, March 2nd, 2016 in Council Chambers, 200 Common Street at 7 p.m. The purpose of said hearing, purpose of said hearing is to gather testimony, information, and public input concerning proposed amendment to the revised ordinances for the City of Lawrence to be further amended by adding the following new paragraph to the handicap parking ordinance. Clifton Street, west side from a point 110 feet easterly of the intersection of Andover Street to a point 130 feet of the intersection of Andover Street. To the extent there exists any ordinances to the contrary, they are hereby repealed to that respect only as published on February 22nd.
Public hearing is now open. Anyone in the audience wishes to be heard? Seeing there is none, public hearing is now closed. Councilors, what's your motion?
Motion to approve.
Motion has been made. Is there a second?
Second.
And properly second. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. Mr. Clerk, please read notice for document 32115.
Document 321, 2015. Notice is hereby given. The City Council will hold a public hearing on Wednesday, March 2nd, 2016 in Council Chambers, 200 Common Street at 7 p.m. The purpose of said hearing is to gather testimony, information, and public input concerning a proposed amendment to the revised ordinances for the City of Lawrence by adding a new paragraph to the handicap parking section to be inserted in proper order. Exit a street south side from a point 245 feet easterly at the intersection of Garfield Street to a point 265 feet of the intersection of Garfield Street. To that extent, if there exists any ordinances to the contrary, they are hereby repealed. Persons wishing to be heard shall be afforded the opportunity as published on February 22nd.
Public hearing is now open. Anybody wishes to be heard? Seeing there's none, public hearing is now closed. Councilors, what's your motion?
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Mr. Clerk, please read notice for document 32315.
Document 323-2015. Notice is hereby given. The City Council will hold a public hearing on Wednesday, March 2nd in Council Chambers, 200 Common Street, 7 p.m. The purpose of said hearing is to gather testimony, information, and public input concerning a proposed amendment to the revised ordinances for the City of Lawrence to be further amended by adding the following new paragraph to the Municipal Code concerning handicap parking to be inserted in proper order. Carver Street, east side from a point 120 feet northerly of the intersection of Salem Street to a point 145 feet of the intersection of Salem Street. To the extent there exist any ordinances to the contrary, they are hereby repealed. In that respect only, persons wishing to be heard shall be afforded the opportunity as published on February 22nd.
Public hearing is now open. Is there anyone who wishes to be heard? Seeing there's none, public hearing is now closed. Councilors, what's your motion? Motion has been made. Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. Mr. Clerk, please read notice for document 32915.
Document 329-2015. Notice is hereby given. The City Council will hold a public hearing Wednesday, March 2nd, 2016 in Council Chambers, 200 Common Street at 7 p.m. The purpose of said hearing is to gather testimony, information, and public input concerning a proposed amendment to the revised ordinances for the City of Lawrence to be amended by adding a new paragraph to the Municipal Code concerning handicap parking to be inserted in proper order. Temple Street, east side, from a point 115 feet northerly of the intersection of Market Street to a point 125 feet of the intersection of Market Street. To the extent there exist any ordinances to the contrary, they are hereby repealed in that respect only. Persons wishing to be heard shall be afforded the opportunity as published on February 22nd.
Public hearing is now open. Is there anyone who wishes to be heard? Seeing there's none, public hearing is now closed. Councilors, what's your motion?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Now moving on to communications from the mayor, city officials, and the city attorney. Document 6916 is a proposed comprehensive financial management policy, and it has been placed on the agenda by Mayor Rivera. Good evening, Mr. Mayor.
Good evening, Council President. Good evening, members of the City Council. Thank you for this time. I, this evening, along with the State Overseer Sean Cronin, bring to you the draft of the proposed comprehensive financial management policies for the City of Lawrence. This is good news, and thanks to Sean and the UMass Boston's Collins Center, Mark Iannello, our Chief Financial Officer, and the staff here in the city, we bring to you a 34-page document, 34 very important pages, as I'll lay out. This document is very technical. It talks about how you manage money, but it really will bring Lawrence from surviving hand to mouth in capital projects and the way we manage our money. And this will make the way we manage our money more programmed and more safe. I don't have to tell many of you who are sitting here 6 years, who are sitting here today, that were here 6 years ago, and some of you that were here 7 years ago, that we entered a time in our city's history where we had a $24 million deficit, and we had to ask the state to allow us to deficit borrow to run our operations. This document is going to be a tool in which we will ensure that we don't go back to those days. Mm-hmm. When finance officials that work for the city have questions about how to manage our money, when elected officials have questions about how to spend our money, the answers will be in this document to allow us to ensure, to allow us to go down a path that is healthy for the taxpayer. And I know, and you sitting in your position, the 4 years that I sat on the other side of this bar, that you know we were always looking for more information. How is it that you're coming to this answer? How is it that you're trying to figure out how to put the budget together? And so this will give us more information on how Lawrence taxpayers' dollars are used and managed. The policies in the document put rules around everything from the way we balance our budget, our enterprise funds, our capital improvement programs and policies, our grant management policies. You know, it's going to talk about how we account and audit financial reporting of our policies, of our money, and put policies around them. Again, these are rules and regulations that elected officials, people that work for the city, will have to use as a guiding force to where we spend, collect, and save and manage our money. We will all be better informed and our money will be better managed. Lastly, I'll tell you, if we do this right and if we play by these rules, everyone, this will not only ensure that our money will be safer, but it will stretch the taxpayers' dollars out to do more and provide better services. Sean Cronin, the overseer, is going to talk about his perspective on this, but I'll leave you with this item on this. There are only 34 pages here, but they're very 34 very powerful pages. I encourage you to go through them. This item is not before you for a vote, but for review. But if you are willing and desire this, we will be make ourselves available to do a more in-depth Q&A at the Budget and Finance Committee on the matter. I'm very excited about this. I'm kind of a budget nerd, so it was a lot of really good things that are in there, but and you may not find the same thing, so we'll come back and do the detail piece. But you know, a simple example is that this is going to be the rules that we use to build the budget. So how do we get to debt service? Well, there's rules inside there how we use debt service. How do we manage our free cash? What should we have on hand? What are the policies around the enterprise funds? Things that today we just don't have. And the biggest bonus of all, not only will it be better spent, not only will it be better, it will be safer, not only will it be better be managed, the rating agencies, the ones that say, hey, here's your credit rating is A or A plus or A minus, they have been dying for us to put this together. So we'll have this on hand, we'll build the budget from these rules, and at the end of the day, I think that we're gonna provide a better product for the citizens and Wall Street and all those folks who look at us to see if we're doing the right thing. And in our history, we haven't had these. It got us into trouble, and I think today it'll make us better. And Sean Cronin will give you some information on his end. And again, we'll be back and be useful to have a longer discussion at the Budget and Finance Committee. Mr. President.
Wonderful. Good evening, Mr. Overseer.
Hello. I'm just going to take up 2 or 3 minutes and just follow up on some of the things the mayor said. So about a year ago, I was before council basically explaining how to end state oversight. And one of the first things I did when I took over this role was to use the overseer budget and bring on the Collins Center. So instead of having it be a stipend, I thought it made more sense to bring in some outside expertise to help do three things. Develop policies, which are before you, develop a long-range financial model, which we'll be talking to you about in 2 weeks, and develop a multi-year capital plan, which we'll get into some detail in 2 weeks as well on the 15th. So what I said just about a year ago is those three things I said a year ago, if the city can develop those, implement those, and follow those, I would be glad to recommend to Secretary of Administration of Finance an ending of state oversight and have her talk to the governor about doing that. So before you tonight is literally the first step in that. It's taken a lot of time, and that's because we were very careful. These are complicated things. They have multi-year impacts. That's why you need a forecast, and that's why we're going to walk through with you the forecast to show you what the ramifications of these things are. So on the 15th, that's what we plan to do. As the mayor said, there's a bunch of stuff in there, how to use free cash, how not to use free cash, how to use one-time monies, how not to use one-time monies, investment policies around your cash on hand, user fees, what should be the policy around developing user fees, and unfunded liabilities. The city, like every municipality in the state, has very large pension and OPEB liabilities that you need to address. But what I want to do is just talk about four items very quickly, and then you can move along. First one is audit committee. There's a recommendation in there to have a formal audit committee, which is something I don't believe the city has now. So this would formalize that there would be a group that reviews the audit and makes a public presentation on it. Risk management policies. Last year's financial statements by the auditors, their management letter talked about the need for having risk management policies. The policies in here say that there needs to be a set of policies put together around risk management. Reserves, Mayor said that Moody's and S&P rate your debt. And one of the things, all you gotta do is every time you borrow money, read it. And one of some of the things I always talk about is reserve levels. So what we have in here is a basically mandatory minimum reserve level stabilization fund. That would be no less than 1% of your revenue stream. And that's there. That's your true rainy day fund for, you know, when things don't go well, you have that in your back pocket. But also a special reserve stabilization fund for litigation costs. You currently have one, but we're trying to formalize that in these policies and set a minimum funding amount for that coming from free cash. So these things all kind of weave together. And then the last one is capital, which is something I'm probably most excited about because I've been told at least a dozen years since the city's had a capital plan. So we're going to present not just a listing of projects, but actually a capital plan, a five-year capital plan that is financed. So the projects that you will see aren't just a wish list, it's actually financed. And what we will do in 2 weeks, because it is, can be pretty complicated, is get into the details of how it works. But in a nutshell, what we're recommending is that whatever your debt service is as a percent of revenue today, maintain that and then augment that by taking a certain amount of free, new growth in your tax levy every year and use that for capital rather than operating. So what you end up doing is over a five-year period, growing your investment in capital, which is something that the city has not done, serious amounts of non-investment in your infrastructure. So go back and read the rating agencies' reports, and they talk about reserve levels, they talk about policies, and they talk about capital planning. Next Wednesday, those other two will be before you. Here's number one. So hopefully, once we review all these and you have your discussions, and as the mayor said, I'm certainly willing to come back to a subcommittee meeting and go through these in detail and when the capital plan's out as well. But a year ago, I said we'd do this, and here's proof, here's step one, and in 2 weeks, we'll have steps two and three. And if the city, as I said, if the city moves forward with these and implements these, not just once, but through a couple budget cycles, then I would certainly be prepared to go back to the person who appointed me and say that I think it's time to end state oversight. So thanks for giving me a few minutes to talk about these.
Thank you very much, Mr. Overseer. Mr. Mayor?
Just a final point on it. Some of these items we may want to make ordinances. Some of them we may not because of the way the way financial management happens and the way the government set up, but that's something definitely that we can discuss as a group, as a city. What should we do with some of them, codify them in ordinances or not? But that's part of the discussion, and I look forward to having a discussion with you guys in the Budget and Finance Committee.
Thank you very much for bringing this forward. At this point, I'd like to reference this document to the Budget and Finance Subcommittee to be able to continue the discussion there with members of that subcommittee. Now moving on to appropriation orders and resolutions. Document 6016. Mr. Vice Chair. To order a public hearing. Okay, so a motion has been made to order a public hearing for document 6016. Is there a second?
Second.
And it's been properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Roll call, please.
Council Reyes.
Yes.
Council DePena.
Yes.
Council Rodriguez.
Yes.
Council Abdu.
Yes.
Council El Monte. Yes. Council Maldonado.
Yes.
Council Alvarez Rodriguez. Noted. Council Vice President LaPlante.
Abstain.
Noted. And Council President.
Yes. Motion carries. Next document is document 6516. It's an appropriation transfer from the Lawrence Department of Public Works, free cash, on the amount of $99,592, and it was placed on the agenda by Brian Pena, Water and Sewer Commissioner, for street lighting, and is going down to the Budget and Finance Subcommittee. Next document is document 7016, an appropriation transfer, Clean Streets Initiative, from free cash to City Street Sidewalks Cleanup, Special Purpose Stabilization Fund, which is a new account, on the amount of $200,000, and it was placed on the agenda by Mayor Dan Rivera, is going to the Budget and Finance Subcommittee. Moving on to committee reports. Document 38714. Madam Chair, from the Ordinance Subcommittee.
Thank you, Councilor President. Document 387-14 is the handicap parking at 63 Main Street, and that came with a favorable recommendation to order a public hearing, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. And discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Madam Chair, document 220-15.
Document 220-15 is the parking Methuen Street north side of Methuen Street between Appleton and Lawrence Street. And that also come out with a favorable recommendation to order a public hearing, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Next document is document 291-15. Madam Chair, from the Ordinance Subcommittee.
Document 291-15 is a taxi cab medallion. Request to transfer medallion to Jose L. Fernandez, present by Luis L. Fernandez. That also came with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Motion has been made. Second. Is there a second? And it's been properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it.
Document 292-15 is a taxi cab medallion petition to transfer medallion to Juana Gomez, present by Jose Gomez. And that also came with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Document 315, Madam Chair. 325-15.
Yeah. Document 325-15 is a taxis license. Luis R. Fernandez requests also a transfer to cap medallion to his son, Luis Fernandez. And that also came with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Next document is document 333-15. Madam Chair.
333-15 is a handicap parking at 17 Bronxfield Street, and that also came with a favorable recommendation to order a public hearing, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Is there any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. Document 2616, Madam Chair.
Document 26-16, I'm looking for a motion to accept as a committee report.
So, motion to accept as a committee report has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Councilor Rodriguez. Document Do we have a representative from Verizon?
Yes. Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Dan Klasnick. I have offices at 210 Broadway in Lynnfield, Massachusetts. Thank you for the opportunity to speak tonight.
How are you?
Good, and you?
And that's located right in front of the Gilmet in Baldur Street. I was wondering to see if you guys find any alternative for that, because it is very, very difficult for the kid to be exposed to any particular hazard. I don't know what type, if it is any, but I know that's going to be an electrical meter there, and I don't know the height, and we don't know what might happen there. Kids are kids nowadays, so just wondering.
Yes, thank you, Counselor. I had provided correspondence on February 25th to Chair Reyes, and I have a copy of that I can provide. But I did speak to my client, and we did investigate. Specifically, you had asked about the height. I mean, it's going to be a standard electrical meter that will be installed in the utility pole. And by NGRID standards, I'm told that it has to be a minimum of 8 feet above ground, so it'll be well above the street level height. In regards to potential alternative locations, just by way of background, the circumstances or the criteria that is used in making a determination of a particular location is based both on the requirements for the wireless service coverage and capacity, as well as the availability of the particular utility poles in the area. In speaking with both the RF engineer, and I did provide some RF information to Councilor Reyes as well, they were able to direct me that the nature of these particular small cell locations, it's very targeted as to what they're trying to accomplish as far as capacity and coverage. So necessarily, the available locations are very narrow. So Verizon Wireless's real estate consultant did go out and look at other locations in this particular area. But in addition to the RF requirements, we're also subject to our licensing requirements with National Grid. And they won't allow us to necessarily attach on locations where there's already existing transformers or other infrastructure. So in cataloging these particular poles, and there were really only two or three poles in the area that would work from an RF perspective, the only one that was suitable both for RF purposes, for wireless purposes, and also made available for licensing purposes was that particular location. So that was in my correspondence. I have a copy of it here if that's helpful.
All right.
Councilor, are there any further questions?
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Councilors, are there any further discussion? Councilor LaPlante, Council Vice President.
Through you. And just to recap, so the idea behind this is to simply to take out some poles and do some overhead. Just very quickly, just a synopsis of what the proposal is looking to do at each one of these locations.
Yes, thank you, Councilor. What Verizon Wireless is proposing to do with these locations, I mean, basically just to step back for a moment. In regards to developing a wireless network, I'm sure as this council is aware, you have to establish certain locations, and it's basically laid out in a grid pattern. And each site has to be sited in such a way that it relates to another site, so that as you move from site to site, if you're driving down the road or if you're walking down the street, you have to be able to hand off from one site to another site. So in these, what Verizon Wireless is finding, and because there's been so much demand placed upon the network, is that the capacity and the requirements, because as you can recall, 10 years ago, all we needed to do was talk on our phones. Now we want to be able to basically carry around a computer in our pocket. So that requires so much more bandwidth and so many more demands upon the network that Verizon Wireless and all the other service providers are really trying to scramble to find ways that they can meet the requirements, provide the services to their customers. So these particular facilities is another way. Verizon Wireless will continue to need and deploy what are called macro sites. Those are the ones you will typically see located on a tower or on a building. These particular locations are intended to be very targeted and just fill in coverage areas where there's particular demands and capacity for the site. So as the plans you're looking at, Counselor, it really will be just limited to a single antenna, a cylindrical canister type antenna that's typically mounted to the top of the pole. There will be mounted on there as well something called a remote radio head. This is just necessary for system performance. There will be no equipment located on the ground. It will be necessary to establish a separate electrical service at each one of these locations. So a meter will be installed, as I had already discussed, at a minimum height of 8 feet. In addition, it's necessary to install and use the existing fiber and electrical at each particular location. So it's really just a canister antenna mounted on the top, some wiring, and an electrical meter and a remote radio head all mounted. I mean, I think it's very similar to what a cable company or a utility company currently utilizes these for. And I'm sure as the council was aware, wireless service providers are entitled to non-discriminatory access to all rights of way and utility poles. So this is really a direction I think that the federal and the state government through the acts and the statutes is encouraging us to do. So, and I think it also reflects a real commitment to the city of Lawrence that we're trying to provide the city with the best possible wireless service, which I think is becoming certainly an essential for operations of business and residents.
So my time is short, but so we're almost required to go ahead and do this because of the federal statutes that require us to have this kind of open and unfettered access to each company for a variety of communication systems. I just want to make sure I agree that I understand that, correct?
I'm sorry?
These mics are awful. I just want to make sure, can you hear me? Is this better?
Yes, hello? Thank you.
Okay. I just want to make sure that the part of the reason that we need to be able to support this because federal law requires that we allow companies such as Verizon and other communications companies unfettered access, or at least some access to be able to provide that service in our city. We can only determine how it may look, where it's located, but you need to have coverage. So by law, if I understand the law correctly, we're required to go ahead and do that.
Yes, I mean, if you look at the statutory and the case law, I mean, in this particular instance, I really look to the statutes that relate to pole attachments. And there's federal act and there's state law where they've mandated the opening of these by the utility providers to wireless service providers.
So the, yes or no, so the answer is yes. My assertion is correct?
Yes.
Okay, very good. And my time is short, so I want to quickly wrap this up. We're having polls. We actually believe utility companies, et cetera, who actually have certain items on our various poles throughout the city. So my presumption here is that this is going to, because the worth and the value of these poles are going to increase, there's going to be a corresponding increase for revenue coming into the city. Is that your understanding?
Well, I guess the best way I can answer that, Counselor, is that, you know, Verizon Wireless will pay any lawfully assessed tax as required. I'm not specifically involved in the taxing portion of it.
Okay. Thank you, Counselor LaPlante. Seeing there's no further discussion, there's a motion to approve as a committee report. All those accept as a committee report. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Counselors, what's your motion for this item?
Motion to approve.
Motion has been made to approve document 2616. Is there a second?
Second.
And properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's no further discussion.
One quick question. I just want to make
Councilor Mark LaPlante.
This is an impact in my district, and many of our districts, and just Council President, just so you're aware, and I want to have this on the record. This will be impacting Parker and Salem Street in District F. And I think it's part of District D as well.
That is correct. All the districts will have an impact in this item except District E. There will be two locations in District B. The rest of our districts will have just one of these locations listed.
I don't think that the person was doing it by
Thank
this
you.
Week.
Motion has been made and properly seconded. If there's no further discussion, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Thank you very much.
No, thank you. Have a good evening.
You do too.
Thank you.
Next document on the agenda is document 3616. Madam Chair, from the Ordinance Committee.
Document 36-16 is a transfer brand license, which is a renewal. It came out with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Is there any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Next document is document 3716, Madam Chair.
Document 37-16 is the Iglesia Fuente de Agua Viva in Salvación request permission to use the common on Saturday, July 9th from 1 p.m. through 5 p.m. for a religious event, and that came out with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Madam Chair, document 3816.
Document 38-16 is a Loring History Center request permission to hold their annual North Canal Classic Roar 5K run, and that came out with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Next document is document 3916, Madam Chair from the Ordinance Committee.
Document 39-16 is a transfer rental license, which is also a renewed one, and they came out with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Next document is document 4316. Madam Chair.
Document 43-16, it came out with no recommendation from a subcommittee, and I make that as a formal motion.
To accept as a committee report?
Yeah, to accept as a committee report.
Okay, is there a second?
Second.
Motion has been made to accept as a committee report and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Councilors, is there any motion for this item?
I make the motion to deny.
Motion to deny has been made. Is there a second?
Second.
And properly second. Any discussion?
Discussion.
Councilor Vice President Maldonado.
From the gentleman as to why this motion is being denied.
Councilor Maldonado.
If we open the door to individuals, nonprofit organizations to start using our city properties, it's going to create a big problem. And I feel that our parks and public properties should be used by nonprofit organizations that are going to benefit the city. And that's the reason why I made the motion to deny.
Okay. Councilors, are there any further discussion?
See. I guess my other question would be, I'm not sure if the committee went in discussions, if there was any, has there been any precedent? Have we allowed for-profit companies? We have a lot of for-profit companies that do work in this, and New Balance comes to mind almost immediately as an organization that does a lot of charitable work, but it's a for-profit company. So I'm not sure how do we deal with something like that?
The reason that If I may.
Councilor Reyes.
The reason that we are denied this was because a lot of questions was being asked. And the first was that we asked if it was going to be any charge, any fee for, and he say no, but if the public wants to give any money, they will take and accept the money. That was the reason. It was a lot of contradiction in what he was saying about this is going to be a free event, and then he's going to say he's going to charge whoever is going to be present.
Okay. Councilor Rodriguez.
Do we have the person here that was requesting the park?
No.
Not here.
Oh, he's not here. So, as part of the discussion that we have on the subcommittee level, it was not quite clear on what he was doing on that day. We know that it was his birthday, and he want to make that as a party and make it free, because free should be everything should be free for everybody, and there's nothing wrong with anything being free. But I mean, it was just for personal use that he was requesting it, and he was not quite clear on what he was doing exactly. It can be a parade, it can be a music concert, it can be anything. And it was a little bit concerning to all of the members at the subcommittee level. I was wondering to see if he was here, because in that way we can clarify all those questions that I currently have for him. I don't believe that it should be denied just because it's been opened to the public, because at the end of the day, the park belongs to the city of Lawrence, and anybody can request it if it's for the right reasons. But on this case particularly, I was concerned because it was just for personal use and a celebration of his birthday. And that's why I'm in favor of denying the permit, but not necessarily because it's been requested by a citizen. So anybody have the right to request it, I guess.
Okay.
So on that, finishing up with my comment, I don't know if Councillor Maldonado would like to amend his motion to deny it because of lack of clarification, and not because of a citizen just requested.
It's not a matter of clarification. It is a matter of people using our public property to promote themselves.
Exactly.
Okay, so definitely this is not what we are looking for. I don't think that we should lend our public property to any group, individuals or groups that are going to promote themselves for their own benefit.
Thank you.
Especially if it is not a non-profit organization.
Do you accept the amendment or not, Councilor Maldonado?
I'm sorry?
Do you accept or not the amendment?
Because you were requesting, because he was opening.
Okay, so
he was requesting, but I mean, can you clarify your
Councilor Rodriguez, Councilor Maldonado did not accept the amendment
okay.
as proposed. Do you have any further questions?
I mean, essentially, fundamentally, we agree.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, I just don't agree with the way that the amendment is being mm-hmm. presented.
Okay. If no other councilors, I have Councilor Almonte, Councilor LaPlante, and Councilor Abdu.
I just wanted to say that I had seconded the motion before hearing that this was more of a birthday bash that this person wants to throw for himself. I would have liked for him to have been here this evening so he could have clarified that for the rest of us here, or if there was any change as to clarifying for the council and the ordinance committee that he came in front of. And seeing that he is not here and that could not be rectified, and hearing some of the reasons why, I would be not voting for this evening. Thank you.
Councilor LaPlante,
please. I have some fundamental questions about this, and I don't feel comfortable with this vote, only because I think there's a lot of unanswered questions with respect to it. When do you allow an organization? Is it private? Is it nonprofit? Is there a nonprofit arm? Are we making a policy right now with respect to it? So I have a lot of questions that I'm not sure I'm going to have answered. Unfortunately, if you're going to be somebody who wants to see the council have to provide something for the council, you should be here to be able to advocate for that. Based on the subcommittee's work, I'm going to go ahead and support this, but I don't want this to be a policy necessarily. The purpose for my doing it is, if you want this to go forward, you need to be here to answer these kinds of questions. And if you're not here, it does a disservice to us as a body to try to make an informed decision, because we can't ask you one final round of questions if there has to be. So I'll cut it right there. I'm going to support it, but with that caveat, I don't want this necessarily to be a policy that we're going to be entertaining.
Okay.
That's my position.
Councilors, any further discussion or questions? Seeing there's none, all those in favor to deny, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Roll call, please.
Council Vice President LaPlante.
Yes.
Councilor Alvarez Rodriguez, absent. Councilor Maldonado.
Yes.
Councilor Almonte.
Yes.
Councilor Abdu.
Yes.
Councilor Rodriguez.
Abstain.
Noted. Councilor De Pena.
Yes.
Councilor Reyes.
Yes.
And Council President.
Yes. Motion carries. Next document on the agenda, it's document 4816. Madam Chair from the Ordinance Subcommittee.
Document 48-16 is a paying broker license. It's a renewal, and that come out with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Next document on the agenda is document 5316. Mr. Vice President.
Thank you, Council President. So the committee in the whole sent up to the council without a recommendation, this docket item, document 5316. It looks like the ML Boscourt Lawrence School Committee member, District A resignation and order of proceedings to fill the vacancy. And I make that just to accept the committee report as a motion.
Motion has been made to approve to accept as a committee report. It's been properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Council President.
Mr. Vice President.
I'd like to make a motion that we select and approve Donna Bertolino as that designee.
A motion has been made and properly second to approve Donna Bertolino. Are there any discussion?
I have discussion.
Real quick. Councilor LaPlante, sure. And Councilor Maldonado.
So I had a chance to review, Council President, both of these individuals, and frankly, I'm delighted that they both decided they're going to want to be a part of being part of this fabric of our school and our school committee system. The reason why I'm supporting Ms. Bertolino over Mr. Castaneda is because Ms. Bertolino has had a lifetime in the education business. Working most recently and for a long term at Northern Essex Community College. She has advanced degrees. She is someone with an incredible amount of abilities. She's volunteer in a variety of different capacities, whether it's historical board or whether it is with one of the charter schools in our city. She comes across, if you just look at the resumes, and again, I'm not saying anything in disrepute for Mr. Castaneda, and I'll talk to him briefly in a second, but her wealth of experience, probably because she's had an opportunity to be more involved, as far surpasses Mr. Castaneda. I think that Mr. Castaneda, who is here this evening, I think that he should continue to be involved in our city, in the fabric of our city. I think there is a place for him. To be involved. He should finish up his educational requirements at the institution that he's in now. It doesn't mean he can't stay involved in any way while he's doing that. But when you have someone of the kind of background that Ms. Bertolino has, it's very difficult to not select someone like that. And I say that out of respect for both candidates. So I would urge my colleagues to support Ms. Bertolino and also encourage and thank Mr. Castaneda for his direct involvement and wanting to be a part of what we're doing here in the city. And let's find another way that we can use his time, treasures, and talents to impact and help our city. Thank you.
Okay. Councilor Maldonado.
Yes. Councilors, while I do recognize the fact that Ms. Bertolino has a tremendous amount of experience, I find that she never took the time really to run for office. That the school committee right now is not exercising its full capacity as a school committee, and that Mr. Castaneda took the time to run for office. He's a young professional that can learn a great deal, in the next 2 years. There's no question in my mind that had the circumstances of the school committee being different, I definitely would have chosen, would have voted in favor of Ms. Bertolino. But I see here an opportunity for a young person who is finishing college at the end of this year to really get educated about the process of our political system in the school department. And that's the only reason why I would not vote in favor of Ms. Bertolino.
Okay. Councilor, is there any further discussion? Councilor Dave Abdu.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I'm voting this evening on the idea that we had the receiver here earlier this evening talking about the point in time when we will come out of receivership or out of being having an overseer and having our fiscal affairs reviewed by the state. We got to this point because of irresponsible actions. We got to this state because we probably made political choices in the past as opposed to the best choice. People of experience making fiscal decisions. I use that as a basis because we also have a school system that is in receivership, full receivership. And that is because of several administrations of poor management, flat out just disgraceful one superintendent who was convicted of a crime. You had a real mess there, and you had a school committee that was at the wheel. You know, they are the policy and oversight of the school system, and we have a receiver now. I think at this time, this city has the opportunity to show the state, show the Commonwealth of Massachusetts that not only can we run our fiscal affairs here at the City Council, the mayor's office, but we can also make good decisions regarding our educational system. And like others here have voiced high thoughts on Mr. Castaneda. He attended high school, my alma mater. Many people have spoken well of him, and I'm sure he's a very good citizen of the city. And I, too, look forward to his contributions in the future. But my concern is the Lawrence school system today. And despite the fact that the school committee, let's be honest, doesn't have any true power right now, I hope we're auditioning to get our school system back. And as part of that audition, I'm interested in someone who brings 30 years of experience to the table. I'm interested in someone who has been at all levels of education. She's an assistant dean at the community college here in this city. She's contributing to this city. She's a homeowner and taxpayer in this city. And, you know, I don't believe I was out of politics for several years, and I think it was a good experience for me. But I never stopped contributing through nonprofits and other efforts of my that I was interested in doing and contributing to my city. And I happen to know that this candidate has done the same. So just because the name isn't on a bumper sticker, I don't think that has any degree of measuring someone's contribution. And I'm just happy tonight that we did have two excellent candidates to choose from, the opportunity of a young man who's hopefully the future of the city and a woman right now that is contributing quite a lot to the city already. And I, for one, look forward to supporting her this evening in another effort to contribute in the public arena and hopefully be part of the answer and solution when we come out of full receivership for our school system and we can once again have local government, local control of our schools by the people. Thank you, Mr. President.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Councilor Abdu. Councilors, Councilor Almonte.
Thank you, Council President. I will be voting in favor of Mr. Castellanos, and I will tell you why. And I agree, Donna has a, she's got her background, she's got 30 years under her belt in education, and she's giving already to the city. Well, we have somebody that wants to join on there and get experience and start doing for the city also.
It's not taken away from what she's doing for the city. Let's let other people who want to join in that, let's let them have their turn also. We can't be greedy and want it all at one time. Regarding a bumper sticker, it wasn't a bumper sticker that he ran. He ran a hard campaign on stickers that he had to go and stand there and have the face and the courage to tell people, here is my sticker, this is why, vote for me. He took the time, it was a long day. It was a long day, we stood there, we had coffee, we talked to lots of people. He had the charisma, he had the courage, and he had the day, the wants. And we should give him that opportunity. Because when you go out there and you fight that bad for what you want, it shows us that that's what you want, and we should give you the opportunity to do so. Experience will come with the growth and with the time that he has. And he's still very young. He's young. He's coming into this full force, looking outside of the political square with all new, fresh experiences still in his brain as to what is happening right now in our educational system, what is lacking, that he could reach out and speak to the children. Because even myself, sometime, when I go in and talk to the kids at the Powhatan School or other children, they look at me as the mom. They don't want to hear me, as young as I may look or as cool as I may be with the kids. See, what he brings to the table is that kids are going to want to listen to what he has to say because he can feel them out. He's not going to be that father figure or that parental figure that kids are like, I'm not going to listen to them. Because sometimes kids will listen to you as the neighbor and won't listen to the parent who is saying the exact same thing. So therefore, coming from somebody that is a fresh open sponge, like I want to say, that has the ability to learn, grow, and be a productive part. And 30 years from now, I'm sure that he's going to have a resume probably better than Donna here in front of us this evening. We need to give him a chance. He needs to start somewhere. She's awesome. She is. But like I said, she needs to start somewhere. And as the District 8 City Councilor, I would ask my colleagues to vote with me for Mr. Castellanos this evening. Thank you.
Councilor, said any further discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 No. All those opposed, please say no.
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 Roll call, please.
Councilor Reyes.
No.
Councilor DePena.
No.
Councilor Rodriguez.
No.
Councilor Abdu.
Yes.
Councilor Almonte.
No.
Councilor Maldonado.
No.
Councilor Alves Rodriguez noted. Councilor Vice President, I'm sorry, Council Vice President LaPlante.
Yes.
And Council President Vasquez.
No, motion fails.
Mr. President, I make the motion that we select Mr. Castañeda.
Second.
For the school
made.
Committee.
Motion has been made and properly second. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Any opposed?
Sounds good.
The ayes have it. Okay.
Congratulations.
Sure. Mr. Castañeda, you will be sworn in immediately.
And repeat after me. I state your name.
I, Emmanuel Castañeda.
Do solemnly swear that I will bear true faith and allegiance.
Do solemnly swear that I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
To the Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
And will support the Constitution thereof.
And will support the Constitution thereof.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I state your name.
I, Emmanuel Castañeda.
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will faithfully.
That I will faithfully
and impartially
and impartially
discharge and perform
discharge and perform
all duties incumbent upon me
all duties incumbent upon me
in the position as the Lawrence School Committee member for District A
in the position as the Lawrence School Committee member for District A
according to the best of my abilities
to the best of my abilities
and
understanding
agreeably to the rules and regulations
agreeably to the rules and regulations
the Constitution and the laws of the Commonwealth
of the Constitution and the laws of the Commonwealth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Castaneda. Next.
Thank you. I just wanted to say thank you to all the city council and for those of you who voted for me and for those of you who didn't vote for me for the advice. And I look forward to working and starting to build up some steam and see what it is that we can do to make these students the best students in Massachusetts. Thank you.
Thank you. Next document is document 5416. Mr. Chair, Council Vice President LaPlante.
The Budget Committee voted with unanimous recommendation and sent to the full council to approve document 5416, which is the Lawrence Police Department FY 2016 Sustain 911 Department of Training Grant and EMD Regulatory Grant for the sum of $129,609. And I make that in the form of a motion.
Motion has been made.
Is there second.
Properly second.
And I'd like to make a 30-day waiver as part of that motion if I haven't already.
With a 30-day waiver, is there any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Document 289A08. Mr. Chair from the Housing Committee.
Yes, this school committee met and voted for a favorable recommendation for a disposition of 50 Crosby Street, tax map 141, lot 48A, to Elvis Vasquez. This is a yard sale, and this is going to be used for parking and green space, and it's been recommended by Luisa Angel. I would like to make this as a form of a motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second.
Question.
Discussion, Councilor Maldonado.
Liza, is Liza here?
Yes.
Through you,
Mr.
President.
St. Ange.
Is Mr. Vasquez has a property adjoining this property?
Who? LV?
We are discussing the sales of 50 Crosby Street. Mm-hmm. Elvis Vasquez the one that is purchasing
yes.
the property? Does he have a property next to it?
Mm-hmm. Yes, he does.
Okay. Is he the sole owner of the other property?
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes, thank you.
Okay. Councilors, are there any further questions or comments? Councilor Rodriguez?
Yes. We discussed this item on the Housing Committee. And by the way, he was using this property without knowing that it belonged to the city. Basically, when he purchased his house, that was his backyard. And they thought that it was his backyard. Essentially, something happened, and they find out that it belonged to the city. They come in front of the city to discuss and be able to buy it because it didn't belong to them. So essentially, they are now actually in the process of suing the realtor that represent them on that sale because they include that portion of land on that sale, and it was not essentially. That's why it came in front of the Housing Committee, and we are recommending this as a yard sale disposition, by the way.
Okay. Councilors, are there any further questions or comments? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. Next document is document 22415. Madam Chair, from the ordinance.
Thank you, Councilor President. 224-15 is a no park in front of Maltmont Street that came out with a favorable recommendation to order a public hearing, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Is there any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. Next document is document 269-15. Madam Chair from the Ordinance Committee.
Yes, document 269-15 is a handicap parking up 66 Osgood Street that also come out with a favorable recommendation to order public hearing, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 The ayes have it. Next document is document 274-15. Madam Chair from the Ordinance Committee.
Document 274-15 is a handicap parking at 191 Prosper Street that also come out with a favorable recommendation to order public hearing, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Is there any discussion? Seeing there's none, All those in favor, please say aye.
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 Opposed? The ayes have it. Next document is document 28115. Madam Chair from the Ordinance Committee.
Document 281-15 is a City of Florence complete street policy and regulation that also came out with a favorable recommendation to order public hearing, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second.
Discussion.
Discussion, Councilor Rodriguez.
Order public hearing. Is McCarthy here? I know it's order public hearing.
Yeah.
Is McCarthy here?
No. He's not going to be here.
All right, no problem.
Okay. So any further discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Next document is document 290-15. Madam Chair from the Ordinance Committee.
Document 290-15 is a handicap parking at 57 Sargent Street that also come out with a favor recommendation to order public hearing, and I made that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Next document is document 4516. Madam Chair from the Ordinance Committee.
Document 45-16 is the Semana Hispana request permission to use the Campon Common from May 2nd to May 8th for their annual spring carnival. And that came out with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Is there any discussion?
Yes.
Councilor Rodriguez.
I just want to put this in the record. I was part of this organization back then, about 4 or 5 years ago, and I want to congratulate them in public, because they are doing this on their own time, their own effort, and there is many volunteers on the organization that actually looking forward to the enrichment of our culture. As a Latino, I will say it, I was part of it, and there is so many things that you guys are doing for the community. And during that week, I remember so many things from my background, and I truly believe that the organization can improve, like you guys are doing, but thank you for doing this, and thank you for putting this event together. Like I always do, like I always said, I'm more than happy to go up there to help out if I have to, and I will be more than happy to support Semana Hispana during this year and year coming up. Okay. Thank you,
councilors. Any Thank further you. Questions?
I just
or want
comments? To say, I'm Marissa Melendez, 64 Aragon, that it's wonderful to see the history that Semana Hispana has brought to the city of Lawrence. And we see people in front of us who've been part of the board and volunteers and all that, and we see people in the audience who've been a part of that history. And we're here to stay, 38 years and strong. Mm-hmm. So thank you for your support. And
wonderful. Councilors, any further questions or comments?
Wonderful week in June.
Councilor Vice President LaPlante.
Sure, so this happens every year, and I think it always falls on me, it seems, to ask this question. The common, we're going to be putting carnival rides, and it's always the question regarding the impacts that a high use such as carnival rides can have on it. It's not like you've got a, it's pretty intense. You've got cars driving on it. You've got these big structures that are on there. Have you been working with DPW to try to figure out the best locations to have those rides just because of the impacts that it could face?
Okay, we have the owner of the Fiesta Show who can elaborate a little bit more on that since he has that experience.
Every year,
good evening, Mr.
Councilor
Flynn.
John Flynn, president of Dean and Flynn Fiesta Shows out of Salisbury, Massachusetts, and Seabrook, New Hampshire. Every year before the event, we actually do a walkthrough either with Nelson Ortiz or someone else from the parks or the DPW. In terms of any new trees that might have been planted, any work they did on the curbs. Last year, as everyone knows, they put in all new curbing in there. We actually built platforms for the equipment to go over it. At the end of the event, they went back through, inspected everything, and everything was signed off. There were no problems, no damage. And obviously, we work with the DPW on that in the Parks Department.
How much, through you, Council President, how much of a bond are you providing for the city?
believe it was a $5,000 bond. I'm not, Counselor, I'm not sure. I think it was $5,000.
Do you know how long that amount has been received by the city? I've heard discussions that there might be a need to go ahead and increase that bond. And
If they deemed it necessary, we would go along with that.
$5,000 is not as much as it used to be years ago, and prices for things that break, et cetera.
I don't believe we started doing the bond.
Especially on the common, where we've spent millions of dollars to make that a nice place for all of our families to use throughout the year. So I just want to make sure that we're preserving that common for use for all of our residents.
I believe it was 6 or 7 years ago, Council, when we started doing the bond. I believe not up until that point. I don't believe there ever was a bond, but it was 6 years ago, I believe, that we started that.
Yeah. Okay. So I guess what I'd be curious just to know, and I'm not going to vote against it tonight, I'll be curious to know how much that bond is. If you can get that information to me in time, because I think because there's other groups that like to do carnivals as well, and I want to make sure that we protect our asset, which is our common, which is historical. We want to make sure that it's left in an even better state than once it was first taken. So we want to make sure that it keeps that.
Thank you, Council Vice President LaPlante. Councilor Almonte, followed by Councilor De Peña.
I just wanted to say that going along with what Giovanni had said, what Semana Hispana does for our city and all culture, if you guys were listening as they said their names, if the last name Melendez rings a bell, it's because the baton has been passed. The family was continuing to do this. It went from Isabel, and now the daughter is here. It shows the kind of the commitment that we have to our city, that we just don't pass our events off to anybody else that just wants to come in and circulate and be part. We allow them to be part of it, but it stays within our families because we are one. We are a family, and it shows, in our culture, and it shows in how we hold things together and what we do and the security that we provide for each other. And it shows, because when you pass it from one to the next and it's still in the same, with the same feeling and all of the same caring, it just resembles itself, because who would want to continue or pass the baton off to something that wasn't worth it? And we're definitely showing that and pushing all our cultures out into so that our kids that are growing up these days don't see just the culture that's on TV, like the MTV or any of that. That where they came from, even though they haven't gone to Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, Costa Rica, or Guatemala, or wherever they're from, Ecuador, or any of the beautiful melting cities or countries and lands that have landed us here and make us the great melting pot that we call Lawrence. You know, we let them know where they came from, and that's awesome. Thank you for doing that.
Thank you. And it's like Giovanni says, we've been growing. It used to be a celebration of our culture, but now we try to look at themes that affect our families. Mm-hmm. And this year's theme is building in the family a better education. So we've reached out to the school department. Our grand marshals this year are principals in the schools of the city of Lawrence, Latina principals, and school workers. We're looking for ambassadors, youth ambassadors, who will promote that. So it's not just about celebrating our culture. It's about celebrating our culture and interspersing that with the theme that affects our families. And our families need to know that your family gets strong if you build education mm-hmm. as part of its foundation. So that's our theme this year.
Awesome. Okay. Thank you.
Wonderful. Councilors, any further questions? Councilor.
Yes, I want to say thank you. I work in HAT for Semana Hispana for 15 years. Yeah. I know for doing the event, you need working HAT. You live in your family, nine, and every meeting. I know you work in HAT. And my congratulations.
Thank you.
Well,
thank you.
Councilors, any additional comments or questions? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Madam Chair, from the Ordinance Committee, document 4616.
Document 4616 is also Semana Hispana request permission to use Campo Como from June 13 to June 19. And that came out with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion?
Discussion.
Councilor Vice President LaPlante.
Just to make sure we have the times accurate. So Thursday and Friday is from 6 to 11. Saturday from noon to 11? No?
This is for the weekend in June.
That's right.
So we don't have Thursday. We have Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Okay, on the...
And just a correction, that Sunday we've requested, and we've always had, from noon to 10:45. The carnival was till 9 p.m., but this is the weekend festivities in June.
Mm-hmm. Let me just pull that up, because on our agenda, it has a different time on there. Just want to make sure it... So on the committee report, just so I'm clear, Thursday, it says Thursday on the committee report.
Yeah.
So it is on Thursday? Are you saying it's not on Thursday?
No, Semana Hispana itself is Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, the 17th, 18th, and the 19th in the park.
Okay. That might be helpful. Okay, I'm just trying to...
Thursday is...
I'm just reading the committee report, and that just says Thursday. That's why I'm asking that question. Are you saying it's not on Thursday? Okay.
We are requesting for Semana Hispana. It's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Okay. So okay. Not Thursday.
No Thursday.
Not Thursday, no.
So there's a typo all over the place on the document.
I think the misunderstanding here is that Thursday, last year's celebration, Thursday night was Dominican night. But they are separate from us. Our responsibility is Friday, Saturday, and Sunday in the park.
And the letter says Thursday.
The document.
Okay, so it's Friday from 6 to 11, Saturday from noon to 11, and Sunday noon to 9. That's accurate?
No.
No.
Sunday 10. From noon to 10:45 on Sunday.
Not what it says on here.
On the application, it's to have the proper time, but if I may, Mr. President.
Councilor Rodriguez.
Yeah, if we look at the application, the actual application, the setup time for the event is going to be at 9 a.m. All the way, and then the event is going to start at noontime, correct? So on the document 4616, we have, I guess, a typo here. And I don't know how can we fix it. I mean, I guess that we have to make a motion to approve the use of the Companion Park based on the application time and time set, which is basically set up time 9 a.m. and end up time on Friday and Saturday till 11. And then Sunday is going to be the same time, but till 10:45.
Yes, sir.
It is okay. I believe it is okay if it is till 11. On the application, it's establishing those times. It is critical to have the park from the beginning, since the morning, because the event will take a lot of preparation, and then if we have no permission, if they have no permission, it's going to be a little difficult to work without permission on the park. So the time from Friday to Saturday is going to be from 9 a.m. according to this setup time to 11 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we need to change, I guess, that the document for the 616 to approve it that way.
Okay.
I just have another question.
Councilor LaPlante.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I just want. So there's one thing to have the use of the common. There needs to be cleanup time. They need to access and do the closing at the evening kind of work.
Yes.
I guess the question that we hit every year is what time is the actual music ending?
The music, I believe, is going to be at, according to the actual hour event, is going to be from noon to 11. The music is shut down a little earlier. At what time?
That's the question.
10:45.
And then the festival?
At 11.
So the Amina. Food. No, Amina. The carnival?
The carnival.
At what time?
Same time.
Mm-hmm. So basically, the actual event, if I may, is going to be from noontime to 11.
Okay, so the concern that I hear every year is not so much, although I hear a little bit, is Friday, Saturdays, but it's the Sunday. If the music continues on till till what time? 9:45?
10:45.
If the music continues on at 10:45, especially on a night where a lot of people are working or kids are going, not kids are going to school, but working the next day, to me, that's long. I don't mind having the comment if you can reduce like by 9 o'clock and saying the music stops then, but continue doing other stuff, but having it, I think the community would be much more appreciative of that kind of accommodation on a Sunday night.
If I may, Mr. President, to you.
Councilor Rodriguez.
Do you have previous contract already set with for that time? So that's what I'm saying. Me being part of that organization, I kind of know a little bit before, not now. And what happened, you have to arrange contracts with autos and many other performers that's maybe a year in advance sometime. And it's depend on how famous the people that are coming to close the event are. So it is a little bit concerning if they take it down at 9 p.m. knowing that they already have contract signs and expensive performance.
Mm-hmm. I wanted to say that we have worked out the contracts. We have the performers. And I think it's something that we can start a discussion on. But for this year, I think it's like Giovanni says, we might be too late because we will lose some of our performers, our key performers.
Councilor Reyes, Councilor Rodriguez, do you have any further questions?
Fine.
Okay, Councilor Reyes and Councilor Maldonado. Councilor Reyes.
For 38 years, this has not been a problem. Mm-hmm. And 10:30, it's not late for a Sunday. Most people go to bed on a Sunday, 11 o'clock, sometimes 11:30. So again, 38 years, it has never been a problem. So I would say that let's keep it that way.
Thank you. Councilor Reyes.
Okay. I'm going to be voting in favor, and this is not something that I'm going to deny, but I just want to ask you a big favor for next year. So whenever you're going to submit the document, please make sure that the date and the dates are correct, because that was presented at Ordinance Committee, and we read it, and we went through, and that was basically the hours that we get. I know for the previous year, we never had any problem. And if one has to comment and say something negative, that would be me who lives close by, and I never heard any complaints. No one has ever called me. But please, for next year, please okay. Do that, okay. Because that really helps a lot.
Yep, sure. Thank you, Councilor Reyes. All those in favor, any further discussion?
One last thing. The contract or whatever that was provided to the City Council, Council President, this was distributed on January 28, 2016. Does say on here that the activities would end at 9 o'clock on Sunday. So I don't know how we're signing contracts that are exceeding what the document that they provide for us says.
For the carnival, it is 9 o'clock.
So it's the carnival that's open till 9, but the music stays on till 10:45?
The spring carnival is till 9 o'clock on Sunday.
But this is for the.
Yeah,
for the
carnival. Just as a clarification. We have to remember that we have the carnival in May,
right.
Followed by the festival
that ends at 9
in June. Okay. Mm-hmm. Right. Councilors, are there any further discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Thank you.
Aye. Thank you.
Good night. Thank you.
The next document is document 4916. Madam Chair, from the Ordinance Committee.
Document 49-16 is the handicap parking at 20 Humphrey Street. That come out with a favorable recommendation to order public hearing, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 The ayes have it. Next document is document 55-16. Madam Chair, from the Ordinance Committee.
Document 56-16, it came out, was a dedication of corner of 342 South Union Street.
55-16.
I'm sorry. Yeah. Document 55-16 is a making a different request permission to use the Camden Common on August 6th from 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. for a religious event, and that come out with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Motion has been made.
I'll second it with discussion.
Discussion, Councilor Almonte.
Thank you, Council President. We have Frankie Caraballo, who is the person who requested for this event, and it's not just a religious event. I would like for Frankie to come up and explain a little bit of what the event entails. It has, I believe the community should know what the event is about.
Good evening, Mr. Caraballo.
God bless you.
So you need an address for the record, please?
Yeah, my name is Frankie Caraballo.
And what your event is about?
My event is like me and my friend used to draw for more than 20, 25 years in Loring. Do a lot of crazy things in Loring. I clean for 10 years. And I got a couple of friends got more than clean, like 5 or 20 years clean. And I believe God. And my plan is make a little party for bringing something to the community. While the team, me and my friend do it wrong in Loring, so I'll do something positive, especially for the little kid, you know? I don't want the little kid you draw or do a crazy thing, you know? I got bad influence back of the day, and today, I try working for the community. I'm helping my people in the bridge. I make an organization, make a difference, helping people. People added want to go to detox. And why I do it that little party? It for town. Thank you for every Loring. You know, especially my family and friend, or the people I do something wrong before. You know, that the plan make it that party. I know the paper says religion, but in reality it's a 50% religion, 50% about recovery. Why I want to do it here, I want to bring a lot of people in recovery, talk about life, why the people do it before and why the people do it today. You know, for the community see, you can do it. You know, and people add it, people can get out for the addiction. You know, I know it's not easy. I know a lot of people don't believe the people know in recovery, but I believe myself. I clean for 10 years. I continue working for the community, and I don't need to go back, you draw, or do a crazy thing, you know? And my party is for all Loring coming and see you can do it, you can change. That's
it. Okay. Councilor Monte.
For those of us who were probably somewhere else or not listening very carefully to what this event is about, it's about making a difference in Lawrence, letting people know that you can make a change if you want to make a change in your life. This is, like Frankie said, he's a person who has gone through some life experiences. He's been clean for 10 years, and he wants to bring out his story and let people know that they're is a better way, that there are many chances, that maybe second chance, third chance didn't work for you, but that there's still gonna be somebody here that is willing to listen, that has gone through what you've been through, and that there are ways to help this happen. As interesting that this is to the city, I believe that we have a huge we know this, it's nothing that is not in the news, and when we have people from the community, so disrespectful right now at this moment. But when we have people from the community, like Frankie, like Dre, everybody that's come out to support this, it humbles. It humbles because it takes a lot of courage to come out here and say that this is the things that you have gone through, and to say your story and to put that out there. It takes courage within itself just to be able to do that, to let people know and put your scars out there so that people could stab at them, you know? So I want to thank Frankie for coming to the community. Come out and show your support, because it's it has everything to do with the homelessness and the reasons why, and why we need certain programs, why we need the federal government and state to get involved, because there is a huge problem. If you don't believe me, go underneath the bridge. I'm over there once or twice a week giving soups and hand warmers, feet warmers. I have a couple counselors that are involved with me on this. Mr. De Peña, thank you so much. And hand in hand, we will get this done, but we cannot get this done by ourselves. There's no way. You can give them 50 coats and 20 blankets, but if you're not there every other day to check in on what their everyday needs are, because they're not going to need a coat. They're not going to need 50 layers of coats, but they are going to need a warm meal every day. They are going to need a change of clothes. They're going to need to take a shower. They're going to need water bottles to brush their teeth. They're going to need some petroleum for their heaters. You know, you wouldn't know what it is that they need if you haven't taken the time to go see what the need is.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Carvalho. Yep. Okay, councilors, a motion's on the floor. If there's no further discussion, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're approved.
God bless you. Right.
Next document is document 5616. Madam Chair, from the Ordinance Committee.
Document 56-16 is a dedication corner of 342 South Union Street and Cambridge Street that come out with a favorable recommendation, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
There's councilors. Please note that we do not have a need to order a public hearing for this one, so the motion, it's simply to approve, correct,
yes.
Councilor?
Yes,
Reyes?
That's what I said.
I'd like to make a motion to table this.
Motion to?
To table so the family could be here at the next meeting.
Motion to table has been made.
Second.
And properly second. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Thank you.
Council President, I just needed to add just one little thing, just point of clarification. For that making a difference, also, Duran is working really, really, really hard. He's the one that does the videos and does the presentations of the people, and he takes the time to go out and do all of this on his own. He goes around and he picks up donations. So if you get on Facebook, you can do it through me, Sandy Elizabeth Almonte, or he's under El Duro Duran. But he's the person that goes around, collects the donations, has the place for them, washes the clothing that comes in, and all that good stuff.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Councilor Almonte. Next document is document 5816. Madam Chair from the Ordinance Subcommittee.
Document 58-16 is Iglesia Fuente de Salvacion request permission to use Campanile Common on August 20. Time change. That will be now from 3 to 2 p.m. Now it's going to be 1 to 2 p.m. because they need time to set up. So the real time is going to be 1 to 9 p.m. to hold an evangelist event, and that make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Councilors, at any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? The ayes have it. Thank you. Madam Chair, from the Ordinance Subcommittee, document 5916.
Document 59-16 is a handicap parking at 60 Juniper Street, and that come out with a favorable recommendation to order a public hearing, and I make that as a formal motion.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Any discussion? Seeing there's none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 The ayes have it. Councilors, moving on the agenda, the next items are withdrawal. There's none. Old business, there's none. Table matters. Councilors, is there anything on the table matters that you would like to discuss?
Mr. President, I make the motion to take document 28215 out of table matters.
There's a motion to take document 28215 out of table matters. Is there a second?
Second.
And it's been properly second.
Discussion.
Discussion, Councilor Vice President LaPlante.
For what purpose through you?
Councilor Maldonado.
We have a situation here that this council is not willing to do anything about it. Temporary appointment of the city engineer, which is supposed to be for 90 days, has extended almost to 2 years in violation of the city charter. And we are still not doing anything about it. We are still allowing the executive branch to violate the city charter and get away with it. Last year, some councilors had the courage to support the cut of the funding of this position, and obviously the money was placed back again. Budget time is coming. And obviously, I hope, I really hope, that this council will have the courage to take the vote again to cut this position because of the fact that this position is in violation of the city charter. The city engineer, the temporary city engineer, will never be able to get certified, will never be able to get certified. I'm going to repeat myself. This city engineer will never be able to get certified under the current conditions. And again, the executive branch is maintaining this temporary position in place against the city charter. So I'm hoping that when the budget time comes, this council will have the courage to cut the position and force the mayor to post his position the way that it's supposed to be. Thank you.
Okay. Councilors, there's a motion. Any further questions, Councilor Vice President LaPlante?
No, just point of order. I asked the question for what purpose, and it's for a discussion, apparently. He pretty much just gave the discussion. I'm not sure if he's looking for a vote on this or what he's looking for. That was the reason for asking the question. I don't know what he's looking to do.
Councilor Maldonado, are you looking to take any form of action?
Right now, I'm not looking for. What I would like to do is to make a motion to send a letter to the mayor, asking him to abide by the city charter and to post a position of the temporary city engineer.
Okay.
I'll second that.
Point of order.
We don't have the document off the table at this point.
Okay.
Councilor LaPlante?
Nope. Okay. I'm aware of what the attempt is now. Thank you.
Are there any additional comments or questions?
Yeah, that's why I seconded for discussion. I just had a quick question. That doesn't get appointed on its own after a certain term has gone by.
Point of order, Council President. No. Point of order. This is a debate to take it off the table, not a debate on the subject matter itself.
That is correct. So in order to engage in a discussion on the matter itself, we will have to take it off the table first. So we do have a motion to take it off the table, which was properly seconded. So in order to engage in the discussion for the document itself, we will have to wait. Unless there's anything specific as to why it's coming now, I'd like to call the motion, Mr. Clerk. The motion was to take it off the table.
Motion to remove from table.
Okay. So, councilors, are those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed?
No.
Okay. Roll call, please.
Councilor LaPlante?
No.
Councilor Alvarez Rodriguez? Noted. Councilor Maldonado?
Yes.
Councilor Almonte?
Yes.
Councilor Abdu?
Yes.
Councilor Rodriguez?
Yes.
Councilor De Pena?
Yes.
Councilor Reyes?
Yes.
And Council President?
Yes. Motion carries.
Yes, I would like to make the motion that we send a letter to the mayor asking the mayor to abide by the city charter and to post a position so that we can get a qualified engineer in the engineering office.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly seconded. Is there any discussion?
Discussion.
Councilor Vice President LaPlante.
Just Council President, to refresh your memory just a little bit about the debate that took place, I guess in the year 2015 on this matter. We had a lengthy discussion regarding temporary appointments. And if you recall, Council President, what we did was I offered, after talking to the mayor, I offered a proposal which the mayor would be willing to go ahead and sign to deal with temporary appointments in general. This council decided not to adopt that particular resolution or particular, I'm sorry, ordinance. And so if we want to revisit that particular ordinance and suspend the rules to allow it to go ahead for further debate, I'd be happy to go ahead and reintroduce it. But right now, it seems like we're changing rules midstream on something like this, and we need to make sure that that we're all working off the same page. And we're going to go ahead and send the mayor a letter, and you know, we can get really political about this. We just need to get answers. We just need to work toward finding out, not through politics, frankly, but rather to try to figure out what's the best way to deal with temporary appointments in the city and start working on that. And I'd be happy to introduce that again.
Okay. We have Councilor Rodriguez and back to Councilor Maldonado.
I'm sorry?
The position is posted on the website.
The position is posted?
Yes, in the website.
When was it posted?
I don't know when, but I mean it's on the website right now. I'm looking at it.
Well, if the position is posted, obviously that's a good move, if that is the case.
No, I just look at it
okay.
Because I saw it before.
Okay. If the position is posted, then I will withdraw my motion.
Okay, motion has been withdrawn. Can I please get a motion to retable the document?
Second.
Motion has been properly made.
The council will make a motion to withdraw. I'll second that motion to withdraw.
Motion was seconded by...
To withdraw the motion?
To withdraw the motion.
To withdraw the motion completely. How about to withdraw the item, Council President?
Okay. Motion has been made to withdraw.
Motion to table supersedes all motions, Council.
No motion to table.
It
was a motion to withdraw.
Yeah. I made a motion to table the...
Just so I'm clear, I'm taking record. I believe Council Maldonado withdrew his...
I withdrew my motion to send a letter to the mayor.
That's correct.
Okay.
Yes.
And there was a motion to table, which was seconded.
Yes.
I second.
Supersedes all discussion and all other motions.
Motion has been made and properly seconded. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The ayes have it. Councilors, any additional documents on table matter?
Yeah.
Seeing there is none, moving on to new business. Document 6116, Handicap Parking, 165 Butler Street, is going to the Ordinance Committee. 6216, Pub Rocker's License, 92 Broadway Street, is going to the Ordinance Committee. 6316, Secondhand and All Gold License, is going to the Ordinance Committee. Document 6416, Parking on Roman Street, Alternate Street Parking, placed on the agenda by Councilor Reyes, is going to the Ordinance Subcommittee. Document 6616, National Grid and Verizon New England, Inc., requesting permission to locate poles, wires, and fixtures on Pembroke Drive towards Marie Drive, is going to the Ordinance Subcommittee. Document 6716, Mass Works, Merrimack Street Improvement Project Supplemental Grant on the amount of $800,000. It was placed on the agenda by the Risa Park Office of Planning and Development Director. It's going to the Budget and Finance Subcommittee. Document 6816, Disabled American Veterans, Chapter 2, request an open hour parking space, 1 hour parking space at 112A East Haverhill Street. Placed on the agenda by Mr. Collins. Is going to the Ordinance Subcommittee. Document 7116, RMB Designs request permission to use Canal Street Bridge to hold the RMB 2016 Fashion Show on May 14th, 2016. It's going to the Ordinance Subcommittee. Document 7216, Residency Requirements, City Employees Home Rule Petition Review, placed on the agenda by myself, is going to the Ordinance Subcommittee. Madam Chair, from the Ordinance Subcommittee, when is your following meeting?
Thursday, which is...
The 10th?
Yes.
Okay. So Thursday, March 10th. Chairman and Vice President, when is your next Budget and Finance Subcommittee?
Next Wednesday, Council President.
Wednesday, the 9th?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Chair, from Housing, is there any items to
I don't think it's
be addressed at the subcommittee level at this point?
Point of parliamentary inquiry, Mr. President.
Mr. Vice President.
Earlier you made a ruling regarding a motion to table, and you were advised by the clerk that that supersedes a motion to withdraw. I'd like just to request that you revisit that issue and say that the motion to withdraw is precedent over a motion to table.
Okay.
I have reviewed what the counsel has shown me in the rules, and it is correct.
Okay. So a motion in that matter, Mr. Clerk, there's the motion to table has... I wouldn't say failed, but didn't...
No, what the council rules are showing in Rule 16, in which Council Plan points out to me, is that there's priority of motions that are in a pecking order, so to speak. When a motion to the table is presented, and then a subsequent motion to withdraw is presented, it has not been seconded at this point, but presented, it should be followed by a second, and then it supersedes in priority over the motion on the table.
In other words, so that means that it has been voted, we should be voiding that vote?
It's a void vote at this point, that's correct.
So we do have a motion to withdraw, is there a second?
That's on document 282.
Document 282. Okay. It's been properly seconded. Any discussion?
Discussion.
Discussion, Councilor Maldonado.
We need to maintain this item so that we can later revisit and see what actually happens with the position. So I would like, since I was the one who put that in the this item in the agenda, I would like to keep it there until we see the actions that are taken by the mayor.
And Councilor Amonte.
Thank you, Council President, for you. And I, being the author of the motion to table the item, I would like for the item to be tabled also. Thank you.
Any further discussion?
Sure. I just want
Vice President McLaughlin.
So, what the councilor at large was suggesting earlier is the reason why he wanted to deal with this is he wanted to make sure this job was posted. He wanted to make sure they went ahead and started the process. We have learned from our colleagues who were able to find out in short order that that process is already in play. So the question that the councilor had has now been satisfied. I'm not sure why we would continue to have this item on our agenda.
Councilors, any further discussion?
I would like to answer.
Councilor, I didn't see you. Councilor Maldonado.
The fact that the position was posted doesn't mean that the mayor may choose not to keep that position, that gentleman in that position, in violation of the city charter. So that's the reason why I would like that to remain in place until a decision for a new city engineer is decided.
Okay. Seeing there's no further discussion, I'd like to call the question. All those in favor to withdraw, please say aye. Any opposed, say no. All those
no.
in favor?
No.
Aye.
Okay. Roll call, Mr. Clerk.
On the motion withdrawal presented by Councilor LaPlante, Councilor Reyes.
To withdraw?
To withdraw the
no.
withdraw the item.
No.
Councilor De Pena.
No.
Councilor Rodriguez.
No.
Councilor Abdu.
Yes.
Councilor Almonte.
No.
Councilor Maldonado.
No.
Councilor Alvarez Rodriguez noted. Councilor Vice President LaPlante.
Yes.
And Council President.
Yes. Motion fails.
Make a motion to retable.
Motion to retable.
Second.
Yeah. It's been properly made and second. Seeing there's no discussion, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Thank you.
The ayes have it. Mr. Vice President, Budget and Finance. You said Wednesday.
Wednesday, right.
Madam from Personnel.
We have no personnel issues, but I do want to say that finally through some of the, if anybody remembers correctly, I think it's item 49, I believe it's 14. It's not on here because I believe it's down in the ordinance, which is the tax incentive, the TIF situation that I have been fighting to put that small clause in there where it says that if they do not comply with the tax incentive forgiveness that we're giving them and allowing them to open a business here within the city, that they would have repercussions to that. Well, we're starting to get some information so we can start moving things forward. I'm just starting to receive information from Mr. Vargas. So on Thursday, January 14th, and this was stamped on January 19th, stating some documents that I have been for a whole year waiting for them to come, and they're finally here. So I will be getting this information out to you guys, and hopefully
Wonderful.
It could be reviewed and sent up to the full council with a favorable recommendation so that we can get moving on this as soon as possible, therefore having been there for as long as it has. I thank them for what they've put together, and I'm hoping that it will satisfy the needs that we have for the city and not complying with certain things that we need and to help everything move forward. So
thank you, Councilor
Amonte. We will
be
moving on that as soon as
thank
possible.
Thank you very
thank
much.
You.
Councilors, are there any further questions? If not, can I please get a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
The ayes have it. Thank you very much.